With just one sheet of puff pastry, you can make an irresistibly flaky and cheesy mouth-watering delight. So get ready to elevate your snack game with this secret recipe of perfect cheese puff sticks. So let's get started. Let us start by preparing the stuffing, that is the cheese and spice mix, along with some fresh herbs. For this, we will need a quarter cup of grated mozzarella cheese. Along with this, we will be taking a quarter cup of cheddar cheese. You can take any cheddar cheese, the mild or even sharp cheddar. It all works. To this, we'll be adding a tablespoon of parmesan cheese, that is the dried parmesan I have taken. In addition to this, we'll be adding some dried herb and spices. That is a quarter teaspoon of dried basil, a quarter teaspoon of chilli flakes, a quarter teaspoon of onion powder, and a quarter teaspoon of garlic powder. We're using dry ingredients to keep the puff pastry from getting soggy. It helps to stay fresh and crispy while you serve your guests. To this, we will add some fresh basil, stack the leaves and roll them up just like a cigar, and using a sharp knife, slice the leaves into ribbons and chop them into smaller pieces. This powerful aromatic herb is known for its pesto sauce, and therefore it instantly gives you a feel of pesto cheese puff sticks, or straws as you may call it. Go ahead and add a handful. Giving this a quick stir, we will set it aside for later use. At this point, we will preheat our oven at 200 degrees Celsius and also get our baking tray ready, lined with the parchment paper. This recipe calls for one sheet of puff pastry, which measures up to 10 by 12 inches. What I got here is a square sheet measuring up to 4 by 4 inches. That's all that I could get from a store nearby for now, but this works fine. So you can cut up your sheet up to this size or just use what you have. Now, going ahead with our recipe, you want to make sure you dust your bench with flour to work with your pastry sheet. And you need to work with cold puff pastry, although not frozen, but not room temperature either. If it comes to room temperature or thaws for too long, it will be very difficult to work with. So I'm just going to roll this out flat, stretching it to be about 5.5 to 6 inches. Now I'm taking one egg for an egg wash, keeping aside a little of egg white in a separate bowl for later use. So we will brush one side of the puff pastry with the egg wash thoroughly on every square inch of the pastry sheet. And here you want to use everything cold, like the eggs I'm using here is also cold as well, as we want to maintain the temperature of the puff pastry. Now, I'm going to go ahead and sprinkle the stuffing. Make sure to be generous enough to cover every inch of the pastry sheet, as you want all the beautiful harmony of flavors in every bite. Now we will place the second sheet over it and gently press it down, making sure all the ingredients have been tucked in well. We will use a pizza cutter, lightly dusted with flour, just to help us cut the strips easily. There's no right or wrong of cutting your pastry sheet. You can either make it thin into sticks like straws, or even thick if you like a big bite of cheese. So here comes the fun part, where we take one of the strips and twist them in the opposite direction and pinch the edges and pressing it down to keep them in place. And if you like more cheese, you can brush it with some egg white and sprinkle some extra cheese and twist it just like we did before. And for the final touches, once we are done with placing the strips on the baking tray, we are going to brush it with some egg white and sprinkle some onion seeds, also known as Nigella seeds. They add a beautiful aromatic flavor and crunch in addition to appealing presentation as well. You can now pop these in the preheated oven for about 10 to 15 minutes. Make sure to keep an eye while baking. Now, while the first batch is baking, I went ahead and made the second batch and froze them just so I could use them for the weekend for the movie night. or maybe even for some unexpected guests. These are super handy for whenever you like. There are more ways than one to make these cheese straws. To make it more like a finger food snack, we can turn it into a pinwheel. You can get as crafty as you like. This is just one way of doing it. So once again, we brush them with the egg white and bake them in the preheated oven for about 10 to 15 minutes. Okay, so our cheese sticks or straws are done and they smell amazing. And the best part is the texture and the combination of flavors which draw you to pick one right away. Which one would you like? Do share your comments below. Time to taste these cheese straws. These homemade cheese straws are incredibly delicious and addictive. They are so flaky, buttery, and packed with cheesy goodness that makes them so seriously addictive that you just can't stop at one. And with the freshness of the basil, they make a wonderful appetizer or a snack for everyone to love. So go ahead and bake these today and share your comments below. Happy baking! Bye for now!